What is shaking, everyone? We're somewhere a little bit different today. Ashley decided to purchase tickets for something very special, something I haven't seen or been to in a very, very long time. Ashley hasn't been since she was a little tiny baby, but we are here for a very special event. We are here at Knott's Berry Farm for their Taste of Knott's celebration. We cannot be more excited. We love food. We love alcoholic beverages. But like I said, we haven't been here in a very, very long time. So come along, we're gonna check it out. The whole park is open. Let's see what Taste of Knott's has to offer. So if you are unaware what Taste of Knott's is, it is a food and wine-esque version of what Disney or what DCA does. They have numerous booths. I think there's 35 booths in all. And Ashley's trying to interrupt. But you can come through. Knott's Berry Farm is completely open. The whole theme park is open, except for the rides, obviously. But you have to get in with a purchase of one of these tasting cards. You get five.
What's
this? What? It's the other parts.
No, but what?
But it's a tasting card with five tastes on it. You can try different booths, different drinks, different food, and explore as you go around. You can purchase other things. You can purchase other taste. You can purchase sarsaparillas. You can purchase other things. But it is a food and wine-esque festival. So we're gonna walk through, we'll show you what we're gonna get, what we're gonna try. A nice lady just gave us a couple of extra cards. How sweet.
Don't know who she is, but she's
we
very
don't know
nice.
Who she is, but thank you. If you
she
do watch,
me.
Thank you. She poked Ashley like she pokes me. So we're gonna walk around,
she
we're gonna show you
that
Ghost
about
Town.
Three on them.
Oh, there's about three on each. We'll see. But we will walk around Ghost Town. That is the main area, Calico. Walk around, show you around. Like I said, I haven't been here in 24 years, 23 years. Ashley hasn't been here
since
she was two. So it has been a while. We're gonna walk around, we're gonna check it out. And let's go get our food on.
I kind of want to do the hand one. I want to see if that's
hard. These here are the boysenberry bites with powdered sugar from booth number G. I love boysenberry pie. It's essentially what these are, except they are deep fried. So I'm very curious to see how these taste. So here we go. It's boysenberry filling, deep fried. It is the inside of a boysenberry pie. That is absolutely delicious. Oh, I could have four more of these and I'm happy. Ashley just told me there's boysenberry salsa.
If
there's boysenberry,
you know what it is?
I'm gonna hit boysenberry. So from booth J, this is the Hatch Chili Mac and Cheese, which looks delicious. So before I try Ashley's Hatch Chili and Mac and Cheese, I got the boysenberry sangria. Oh, very berry, not too winey, you know, alcohol flavor. Ashley's taking it. Okay, now I'm gonna try the boysenberry wine. Oh, okay. The boysenberry wine, a lot better than the sangria. It's really sweet.
Good, you can keep that.
It's really sweet. But, oh, that goes down smooth. Okay, if any of you have seen our past videos where Ashley tries to feed me, let's see how this goes.
Did I do good? I'm trying to learn.
You did good.
Trying to learn. It's literally just mac and cheese.
It's mac and cheese. Yeah, with like a crunchy jalapeno though.
I don't know.
It's jalapeno mac and cheese, but there's definitely a crunch to it. I don't know. That's really good. So from Jay, we got the Hatch chili mac and cheese, the boysenberry wine, and the boysenberry sangria.
They're both out of the beer.
The sangria and the wine are good. They're out of the beer.
Right now.
And Ashley has already traded me the wine and sangria. So she took my sangria. I'm taking her wine. I've got no objections. She likes to wine. So she gave me the wine. So we're going to continue on. We're going to finish up here. Continue on. Look around. Because like I said, we haven't been here. And for me, it's been 24 years at least since I've been inside of Knott's Berry Farm. Ashley, 22 years. So it's been a long time. So we're going to walk through. We're going to take some pictures. Take some kind of B-roll shots. And we'll see kind of what else we get. I'm looking for some more alcohol. I want like anything boysenberry, especially boysenberry alcohol, I want to try. Outside of that, no idea what we're gonna do. So over at Booth M, which is the Calico Saloon, Ashley got a boysenberry smoothie. Really sweet, but not bad. I, on the other hand, boysenberry beer. Kind of looks like it's an amber, a little bit lighter beer, not quite an IPA.
You get a bigger cup when you buy.
Yeah, so if you purchase, if you purchase the beer and not use the tasting card, if you actually purchase the beer, you get a full 12-ounce cup. But if you are just using the tasting, which is a value of $6, you get one, which is plenty for me, at least right now. Honestly, it kind of just tastes like a Pilsner. You ever had a Pilsner? Imagine that. It's Pilsner is kind of an in-between between an amber and a normal lager. So you have an amber, which is more of a redder toned beer, and you have a Budweiser, a normal lager. Pilsner is kind of in between. That's kind of what this is. It's not overly heavy, it's not overly hoppy, but it's not quite light, like a light beer. If it was a light beer, I wouldn't be drinking it. But it doesn't have a lot of fruit. It doesn't have a lot of boysenberry flavor to it. Ashley's making a sour face. But to me, it's not bad.
I really need to learn to stop trying.
If you're gonna use the tasting, use it on the boysenberry wine or the boysenberry sangria. The beer is good. Okay. It's not quite worth the value. So the beer is good. I would recommend the wine, the boysenberry wine, or the boysenberry sangria. Just a quick little addition. Ashley just said she can sip on this boysenberry smoothie all day long. To me, it's more of an icy. Down the road from where we used to live, there was a place, Quick Stop, like a 7-Eleven Quick Stop, and they used to have, it was more like a slush ice, you know, like a chopped up ice, rather than your typical 7-Eleven icy. That's what this is. It's more like a Sonic's icy with boysenberry flavor. Unbelievable. And she's just like, oh, here, finish it. I'm not big on sweets. I can't do a lot of sweets. She just can't stop. This is the first thing where she's like, no, what? I can get another one of these.
My teeth are probably gonna be purple.
Everything's gonna be purple. And the funny part is she hates boysenberry pie. She can't stand boysenberry pie. Anything else boysenberry, she can't get enough of.
Steve, why did the Clydesdale give the Shetland pony a drink of water?
Why?
Because he was a little horse. A little horse. You get it? You get it? She don't get it. Oh, corn. Ma'am, do you know how much a pirate would pay for that corn?
A buccaneer.
A buccaneer is absolutely right. Got to get up pretty early. All right, here's one. What's brown and sticky? A stick.
So I was going to do a little rundown while we were eating, but they had a DJ going and the music was too loud. You would have never heard me. So the first one here is a beef and pork sausage. The one in the middle is a peaches and cream popping boba. It is basically a cream milk tea with peach popping boba. And last but not least is a corn on the cob with a boysenberry butter and kocha cheese. Now, the corn on the cob was really, really good. Ashley thought the cheese overwhelmed it a little bit, and it did, kind of. But the boysenberry butter went perfectly with the corn on the cob. Yes, both are sweet on sweet, but the boysenberry wasn't overly sweet to kind of give it a really sweet, you know, flavor profile. And to go back to the tea, the peaches and cream popping boba tea, the popping boba itself is very, very peachy. It's very sweet. So when you first drink the tea itself, it's not bad. But when you add in the popping boba, it makes it very sweet. Now, if you have a nice sip with only one or two, you know, popping boba, it's not bad at all. The combination goes great. Ashley's sitting here singing in the jungle, the mighty jungle. But when you only have a couple of the popping boba with the tea, it pairs perfectly. But when you have too many of the popping boba, it kind of overpowers the tea itself. So out of the three, I would recommend the corn for sure. Definitely the corn. The sausage is a maybe. If it was spicier, I think I'd like it more. And the tea, I would probably put third, you know, number three out of them. I'd put it last, just because it's too overwhelmingly sweet. So we finish up here. We're gonna walk through. We're gonna check out a whole bunch of the park. We still have about 2 hours left. So we've got a lot more to try, a lot more to see. So we're gonna finish up and head on through the park. So on to our next booth, and it is the R booth. We only got one thing. There's a lot of things we could have tried here. We could have tried the fries.
What does the pirate say?
R? Actually trying to tell a joke. It doesn't work.
What's a pirate's favorite?
What is a pirate's favorite letter?
R.
Anyways, back to the R booth. We could have got fries, which looked good. It was fries, pico de gallo, and carne asada on top. But we ended up going with the boysenberry margarita. Now, Ashley, she got the tasting. I bought one. Okay, Ashley bought it for me. But here's the size differences. You can kind of see, I'd say it's two-thirds of this size. So the tasting is about two-thirds of this one.
It's got something else in it, I can't.
So honestly, it tastes like a boysenberry and Coca-Cola slushy.
Ooh, that's a good, like, mixture. It's like cherry Coke.
Boysenberry and cherry Coke put together into a slushy. It's not too bad. It's really good. For my drinks, I like to be able to taste the alcohol just so I know that there's alcohol in it. Not that strong. You can tell it's out of one of those, you know, I tap the keg kind of thing. It's one of the pre-mix mixtures. But overall, it's not bad.
So the strongest alcoholic drink you want is probably the wine.
Right.
The wine, you can taste the most alcohol.
It does taste delicious, I will say that. And like Ashley was just saying, I don't know if you can hear her. The microphone's pointed at me. She's off to the side. The wine and sangria are still, you know, the best options if you want to try to get a buzz, to get your drink on. Wine and sangria, beer, obviously. This is not a bad option though. If you just want to come and try something delicious, especially now that the sun's going down.
Like, sip it and like you get like two or three.
Oh, you can get a few of these and this would sneak up on you quick. But it basically tastes cherry Coke slushy with some boysenberry syrup. Not bad. We're over here in the boardwalk section. It is turning into a gorgeous, gorgeous evening. I'm gonna show you who's sitting here next to us as long as he's still here when we're done. But This is turning into a great, great time out here at Taste of Knott. Since we are starting to wind down here at Knott's Berry Farm, I thought I would take a quick moment. We were kind of worried that the portion size would be kind of small and you'd have to buy extra tastings to kind of get your fill here. That's definitely not the case. All the portions are quite large. Now, I've seen a couple that are smaller, but I've also seen some, like our mac and cheese, that is very much a full portion. So it's something to keep in mind if you are worried that certain portions aren't going to be big enough, or is the value of the tasting worth it? It definitely is. I mean, we have three tastings left and we're kind of wondering where to put it. Like, my tummy's full, Ashley's tummy's full, we don't know what to do. So definitely it is worth noting that each tasting is quite large. So we've got a few more left. We're going to check out Fiesta Village here, and I think some fries with some steak on them is kind of calling our name. So this here is the carnitas fries from Booth X here at Fiesta Village. It's fries, what Ashley just said. It's fries with carne asada and some pico de gallo. we're so used to watching Brooklyn Nine-Nine and Marshawn Lynch, where he complains that he didn't get his pico de gallo. But it's carne asada fries with pico de gallo and pico de gallo and sour cream. I'm never gonna get it right. It shows you how much we watch Brooklyn Nine-Nine.
It shows you how much we watch Brooklyn Nine-Nine. No matter how many times I try, I can't say it right. So it is carne asada on top of fries with pico de gallo and sour cream. If I try hard enough, I get it right. But it looks pretty good. Ashley's tried the fries, which seems pretty good.
When it first opened.
Yeah, right at 12 o'clock it might be really, really good. Instead of waiting until nearly closing, it's 8 o'clock, we have an hour left. So near closing, might be a little better, a little more fresh earlier on in the day, but it's not bad. And again, it's a huge, huge portion. And it's nice after all the alcohol we're drinking, we just have the boysenberry items. So it's a nice little refresher, a nice little shake. And I would just like to give a quick little shout out to the one who asked me who we were, what vlog you should be watching right here outside of number X or letter X. It is great to have you on. I'm glad you're watching. And to the guy that was just dancing behind me, right on. So we're gonna enjoy this. We'll move on. We just had an announcement. Only an hour left. So see how much we can accomplish in such a short amount of time.
So our last stop for the night is at the L booth here at Calico. It's right on the border of Calico, Ghost Town, and the Boardwalk area. It is a blue velvet lemon cookie witch with vanilla soft serve in the middle. It's massive. It's huge.
You good?
I'm good. Wow. That is delicious though. That is delicious. Ashley, can you hold? And I gotta show you what Ashley got. Ashley got this bad boy. It's an icy. But let me go through, I can't remember them all. It is orange Fanta, blue raspberry, red cherry, and yellow lemon icy. It's an icy. You can't go wrong with an icy. So an icy, what? You can't bite it. Ashley can't even bite it. That's a big sandwich. And it's kind of hard. The cookie's really hard, but soft.
Like a macaron, whatever you want to call it.
Oh! Ice cream's going everywhere. No matter. It's still delicious. So if you want dessert, highly recommend the L booth here. It has a big ice cream on the side in between Calico Ghost Town and the Boardwalk District of Knott's Berry Farm. So that is going to do it. We had an absolute blast here at Taste of Knott's today. We were here for about 3.5, 4-ish hours, saw everything, tasted way too much food, way too many drinks. Just, it's well worth the money. That's all I have to say. But like I said, we had a blast. We had a blast. This is currently going on Friday, Saturday, and Sunday, every weekend, until September 13th. Now, that is just the tentative date. They have extended it before. And if the parks don't open by then, like actual theme parks reopen, I could see them continuing on and extending it further. So right now, September 13th, come on down, $30 tasting card. We had a blast. So without further ado, if you haven't already, give this video a big thumbs up, hit that subscribe button, hit that notification bell if you want to see other videos like this or other park adventure videos are uploaded. And as always, tell everybody that we say hi, tell all your furry friends hi, give them a pet, give them love, and I will see you all a little later.